Hello, viewers. God, that was a bit James May, wasn't it? Hello, viewers. Anyway, hello. Welcome back. I've been hearing a lot of buzz online about the Carnaby HE2 from Cranborne Audio. Well, it just so happens that Sam at Make Noise Pro Audio happens to be a dealer for Cranborne and has the HE2 and kindly sent me one so I could take a look at it and see what all the hype's about. So I'm going to give you my 2 cents on it, for those of you that are interested, tell you what I think this is best used for. It's, I wouldn't say it's marketed as, but it definitely comes across like an EQ. It is not an EQ. Kind of. It is of sorts, but it isn't. Let me explain. It looks like an equalizer. It smells like an equalizer. One could say it moonlights as an equalizer. But what it actually is a multiband saturation device. Much like FabFilter Saturn. So for any of you out there that have got Saturn 2, kind of does a similar thing, but it sounds distinctly different. See, Saturn has all of these different, you know, tape, tube, destroyed radio, yada yada, all these different settings. The Carnaby doesn't have that. It just has the Carnaby sound. To me, it's a distinctly different flavour than anything that Saturn offers. In fact, than almost anything that I've heard offers. It's very, very nice. Now let me walk you through the features. All right, so taking a look at the front of the HE2 first, what we've got here in the centre section are 3 buttons. We've got dual mono operation, stereo operation, and mid-side operation, and then your power button is at the bottom. This is channel 1, channel 2, if you're working in dual mono or stereo, and this will be your mid-side, and this will be your side, which is labelled here for avoidance of doubt. It also has an insert circuit, so if you want to insert something in the signal path, you can do. Now over here you've got low filter, high filter, which are selectable per channel. And then you've also got the bandwidth at which the high cut and low cut are enabled. And you have excellent clicky buttons. There you go, you can just turn them up, lovely. Getting in a little bit closer, you can see the low band, mid band and high band. These have selectable frequency levels where you can see some markings here. There's 12K, 25K, 1.5, 6.2, 420, 100, etc, etc. So basically in between those markings, best guess what it is. I don't want to be that guy, but use your ears, bro. And then you've also got the amount of gain or the amount of reduction per band. Pretty simple. You also then have in and out switches. So they will light up accordingly, depending on whether you've got them in or out. That's pretty much as simple as it gets. Those are the controls on the front. Let's move on to the plug-in operation. Okay, so looking at the Carnaby plug-in, there's one issue if you're a Pro Tools user, and that issue is it's not available in AAX yet, although I am told this is on its way. Now, you can connect to the Carnaby via USB or Ethernet. Now, I have tried Ethernet, but I can't seem to be able to get it working. However, I'm not going to take any points away from the HE2 because I have a feeling it's my network setup and connectivity that is actually preventing connection. USB, however, works absolutely flawlessly. Now, as you open the plugin, you will see all of the features that are on the front panel represented in the plugin. So, output, input, your bands, and as you can see, all the buttons on the front light up. If we go to the other side, nice. Now the good thing about the plugin is you can see the exact values that you're actually adjusting and the exact frequencies, which you can't see on the front of the unit. So it is quite handy. Now, I was playing back this track, Image of Grace by Aaliyah Rye. There will be a link in the description box below if you want to check that track out. But I've put the Carnaby on the master bus here, and let's just zero it out. And a nice little mastering trick is as follows. You adjust the low end So let's go, I don't know, 70, let's go 70 hertz. Can we, oh, we can double click as well. Cool. And what you do is you boost this in the middle. So we've got it in mid-side mode at the moment. So we disengage the other two bands and we boost it up the middle. Let's have a listen. Now what we do in the side channel is we turn the other two bands off and we boost the top end, 10k. And we boost that only in the sides. Let's have a listen. So yeah, there's a nice little subtle widening effect, almost. So it's really, really good for that. If we go to stereo operation, you'll see that this side of the plugin gets greyed out and all the controls are controlled by the left side. In dual mono, obviously, both sides will become active again and it's just channel 1 and channel 2. Now here's a little hack for you. If you adjust these to, you know, wherever you want, on stereo mode, and then flip it to dual mono, it will actually copy the settings across to the right. So rather than have to adjust both your settings twice, stick it in stereo, make your adjustments as a stereo item, and then flick it to dual mono if you want to do that. So that's a cool little trick for you. Now, let's have a listen to the bass. Let's zero out again. And we're going to stick it in stereo. That sounds amazing. Just immediately lifts the bass. That sounds absolutely incredible. Nice. All right, let's see what it can do on the guitar boss. Let's zero it again. Wow, it really lifts everything out that it touches. That's incredible. Finally, let's have a quick look at the vocal bus, because I've got quite distorted sounding vocals on this. So let me turn Decapitator off. Shifter in our lives, hold our breaths when you walk by. We don't have the time to be chastised. We don't have the time to fear your eyes. Your nose, you'll freak out if she hears the truth. Now also, let's drive the input and lower the output. Shifter in our lives, hold our breaths when you walk by. We don't. She hears the truth, will horror come to an end?
when you walk by. We don't have the time to be chastised. We don't have the time to fear your cries. Your nose, you'll freak out if she hears the truth. Will horror come to an end? Your nose, you'll freak out if she hears the truth. No more trouble.
Whoa, that's cool. A couple of other things I wanted to mention about the HE2. So the plugin usage, as you've seen in Pro Tools, can be a little bit janky from time to time, especially you have to use it via Blue Cat Patchwork. So negative points for that against Cranborne, because they really need to sort AAX out. It's not like Pro Tools isn't popular, so come on. Now, I do believe it is on the way though, so fair enough. But I mean, you would really have hoped they'd have got that sorted before the device released. Apparently not. The other thing, in fact, no, do you know what? There is no other thing. I can't think of anything negative to say about this. I wanted to try to be as balanced as possible, but this device is awesome. It sounds great. It sounds absolutely great. Any source I've used it on, it works perfectly in moderation. That being said, you can full send it as well, and it sounds just as good. I've even used it in mastering. Sounds great. Another thing to mention as well, going back to the BetterMaker thing from the previous video, hardware controlled with plugins. No, it's not a bad thing. You know, if Cranborne ever go out of business, you're still going to be able to use it. All the features in the plugin are just mimicked from the buttons on the front. It can work completely without the plugin. And it is a fully analog signal path. There is no digital in there to speak of. It's fully analog signal path. It is an analog piece of gear. It's just controlled digitally on the front panel, which can then be subsequently accessed via the plugin. That's the benefit of it. And I think that a lot of modern hardware is going to go down this route. And I'm all about it. I'm for it. It is a lot easier. You can say presets. You've got recall. Does make the job a little easier to do than having to pen out recall sheets or use a plugin like Session Recall or, you know, whatever. Just kind of takes that out of it. So it is cool. The one thing that does worry me, though, is what if you were to build up quite a few pieces of modern gear that are USB controlled? Are you going to have 65 USB hubs plugged in? Like, what if you're in a big facility? That's quite worrying. But I do like the fact that they've also included network interfaces on the back or an interface, because it would be a lot easier to have an Ethernet switch and have all your gear plugged into a switch. That would be a lot easier, kind of down the same route as Dante, I guess. And then it would be infinitely scalable, because USB buses get saturated eventually. So if you had enough pieces of gear, it'd be an absolute nightmare. But over Ethernet, it would just be delightful. And I don't think you'd really run into a problem, to be honest. USB is good for if you've got a few devices, sure. But if you're going to run like a big facility that's got a lot in it, you probably want to consider going down the networking route. All right, there we have it. That's the Carnaby HE2 from Cranborne Audio. These are available now from Make Noise Pro Audio. There is a link in the description to the Carnaby page on Sam's website. So if you want to pick one up for yourself, go over there, check them out. And whilst you're there, maybe do a little bit of shopping for some other bits of fancy gear as well. Anyway, thanks a lot for joining me, and until we meet again, take care.